Of the 8 former All-Stars that switched teams this offseason, 7 of them went east to west, including Melo, after being traded to OKC. Max,
yeah.
This legitimized the Thunder as the number one threat to those Warriors.
In the West. Not overall, because Cleveland still has LeBron James, Isaiah Thomas. They're expecting back halfway through the season, which means he'll be ready for the playoffs. He'll have enough burn before the playoffs to be ready, be in basketball shape. And if you have arrested Isaiah Thomas in the playoffs, and he's even most of what he normally is, that's a star player on offense, at least, who can approximate just about everything Kyrie can on offense. Kevin Love, still. You got Crowder in the trade, who's kind of exactly the type of player they've been missing so far. The Swiss Army knife. You know, do everything, be able to switch on defense, shoot the three, kind of sort of answer to Draymond Green in his way. And they got a lot of stuff. Tristan Thompson still, the Cavs are still loaded, and the best player in the universe by a lot, by the way. I like Kevin Durant and Kawhi Leonard a lot. LeBron's in his own class. So the answer is still the Cavs. I love the Thunder, not when they have Roberson at the two here, I don't think, Stephen A., which may be the plan. I like the idea of Paul George at the two, and if they play him that way, boy, that starting five is vicious. Westbrook, George, Carmelo, Patterson, you know, who can also shoot and do all these
Patterson
kind of things.
Patterson won't be starting,
though. Right, right. I know that he won't be. That would be my starting five. If you said that's the starting five, I'd think, all right, well, you know, you got your work cut out for you, everyone else. But as it is, also, you have multiple chances to get bumped out before the finals if you're OKC in the West, mm-hmm. let alone against the Warriors. The Cavs still have a pretty much free ride, apologies Celtics, mm-hmm. so long as Isaiah can play, to the finals. So I think the Cavs remain the biggest threat.
Number one, this is your starting five if you're Oklahoma City. I'm telling you what.
Say Roberson at the two.
No. It's going to be Russell Westbrook. You've got Paul George. Mm-hmm. Roberson is going to do much of the work at the three for you. He's basically there for defense because we know he
can't. 2-3 nowadays is like the same thing.
He can't shoot to save his life. We know that. With Steven Adams and Melo, that's their starting five. That's what their starting five is going to be, according to folks that I spoke to this weekend. Things could change or whatever, but you got Patterson, you got Raymond Felton, who they think is a big deal coming off that bench just to spell for you and keep things steady from the point guard position, which is something they didn't have to rely upon last year in their estimation. No matter which way you slice it, they're happy with that right now. I'm going to sit up there and say to you, I understand why you have Cleveland as the number one threat to Golden State. For me, I do not, only because I need to see Isaiah Thomas healthy first. Mm-hmm. Hips are no joke. And I got to see you. I mean, again, I respect
I hear that.
I'm saying it's not enough for him to come back. He will be back. My question is, how much of you is going to return based on what we saw last year? Until I see that, I'm going with Oklahoma City as the number one threat to the Golden State Warriors.